Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Paathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic is the public health topic, which is the epidemiology. So epi means among, demi means people, and logy means study. So we are going to study on the preventive medicine. How do we prevent a disease? Nowadays we have the coronavirus. So how do we prevent this disease? For that, we have the epidemiology, which is the study. So we are studying. So this is the epidemiology. So without further ado, let's get started. So guys, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. So last video we have talked about the prevalence and the incidence, and prevalence is equal to incidence into the duration. This we have learned in the previous video. So this video we are going to talk about, as we had three terms in the epidemiology, three D's if you remember. So disease frequency we have covered. Now this video we'll be talking about the description. Describing, so it will be a descriptive epidemiology. So describing what, why, when, 5 W's and 1 H. So what, why, when, where, and who, and 1 H, how. So this is the about all these questions about the disease. So time. So we have time, place, and person, right? So time, when the disease is occurring. Place, where the disease is occurring. And person, who is getting the disease. So this is about the descriptive epidemiology, the time, place, and person. So when the disease is occurring is the time. So it will be the time distribution. Where the disease is occurring is the place distribution. Who the disease, who is getting affected, who is getting the disease is the person distribution. Right. So basically the disease rate, it can vary from time to time. So before we get ahead, let's just see who is the father of modern epidemiology. So the father of modern epidemiology is the John Snow. So John Snow, he gave a spot map. So while during the epidemic of the cholera, so he told that wherever water services are there, and he saw that these closer to the water services, adjacent to the water services, there is the spread of cholera. So he gave a spot map for cholera. Okay, then that is why he is known as the father of modern epidemiology. Coming to again describing a disease, right? So describing a disease, if we are talking about time, then you know actually the spread of the disease, or we can say the disease rate, it can vary from time to time. Like some diseases, they can spread very fast. Some diseases, they take lot of time, and prevention also same thing. So there are, if we look at the time trends of the disease occurrence, so it can be a short term when the disease is only taking weeks, months, or year for the occurrence periodic. That means the disease is occurring in the periods. So either if it is occurring in 1 year, in 1 year in the seasons, then it is the seasonal. Cyclic is, see, cyclic trend is after few years, there is a repeated trend of the again reoccurrence of the year. So every year actually disease is there, but cyclic trend, all of a sudden people are dying after some years. Like suppose after 6 or 7 years, the disease is coming back again and it is killing so many people. Then it is the cyclic fluctuation. Then the long term or the secular trend. So the long term or the secular trends are the trends which are coming from years. So if we are looking at, suppose if we are looking at tuberculosis, so if we are looking at tuberculosis, then it is coming from it is a chronic disease which is in there for a long period of time. So for a long term we are seeing these trends, we are seeing these fluctuations are the long trends. So first of all, starting about the short term fluctuations. So short term fluctuations, these fluctuations are actually in a very, very less period of time. So these can be the food poisoning, road traffic accident, because all of a sudden, if a person is having a road traffic accident, then this is all of a sudden. And also food poisoning. So this is all of a sudden. After having the contaminated food, food poisoning is there. Or we can say this Bhopal gas tragedy, which happened on 2nd December 1984. So in this Bhopal gas tragedy, what was there? There was a release of the poisonous gas. So somewhere around 45 tons of the methyl isocyanate was released at the Union Carbide pesticide plant in the Bhopal. So this was such an incident that it affected a lot of people. So that was a short-term fluctuation. So it was just a release of the gas and it hampered a lot of people, right? And also any accident, nuclear accident, like Chernobyl disaster in the Ukraine. So like that, we have incidences which are occurring at the short point of time and which is causing disaster of a which is causing an epidemiology. So, which is affecting a lot of people, right? Then coming to periodic fluctuation. So, periodic fluctuation is, we have two things. One is the seasonal, another one is the cyclic. So, if we look at the seasonal, is the infection is occurring in seasons every year. So, in 1 year, suppose whenever winter season is coming, that infection is spreading. Or cyclic means it is coming once in few or several years. So that is a shift. So if we look at the cyclic, then cyclic is actually a shift of the virus, like a small mutation of the virus, we can say. So basically the virus, which looked like this before. Now what happens over several years or few years of time, there is a shift in the mutation of the viral structure. So a new subtype is formed due to gradual shifting in the structure of the virus. So now the virus is mutated. So this is the cyclic. There is an antigenic shift. So if there is a shift in the antigen. Now coming to the seasonal or cyclic trends. So, if we look at the vector-borne diseases, the diseases which are coming from the mosquitoes are usually occurring in the rainy season. For example, outburst of malaria. For example, outburst of malaria from female anopheles. It mostly occurs in the rainy season. Then the dengue. Dengue also in the rainy season from the Aedes mosquito, Aedes aegypti mosquito. Then also we have polio. See, polio is now eradicated from India. But earlier when it was there, polio was from the polio virus and the root was the fecal root. It was most commonly seen, like it was there throughout the year, but it was most commonly seen during the rainy season. Also, we have so many diseases occurring in the winter season. Why in winter season? Respiratory. Especially when you look at the respiratory diseases, when you look at the diseases in which the respiratory system is get affected. So, airborne diseases, I must say. All the airborne diseases are usually seen in the winter season. Suppose, if we look at the measles. Now, measles is causing from rubella virus. So, it is occurring in the winter season. Again, it is affecting children. There is coughing, sneezing. And also, if you see the mumps. Now, mumps, as a dentist, we have already studied mumps. So, there is going to be a swelling in the parotid gland. It can be unilateral, bilateral. And actually the swelling increases for 1 to 2 days, then it start decreasing. So usually when you see the swelling close to the angle of the ear in the children and which is spread by the airborne respiratory droplet. Now all these things we give the MMR vaccine, right? Measles, mumps, rubella. So all these, and we have so many, we have rubella coming, that is the German measles. Actually, see, if you look at rubella, so it is also affecting the pregnant woman. So it is going in the bloodstream. So there are red rashes, there is fever. Also chicken pox, you must have seen chicken pox. Now, chicken pox is usually seen in the children also, but again, it is seen in the adults. Then chicken pox, then we have influenza, which is also a seasonal flu, which is seen in the winter time. Now, a modification of influenza is our coronavirus. Right, So then we have diphtheria, pertussis, or when you look at the hay fever. Now even I have hay fever. So hay fever is basically pollen allergy or dust allergy. This is usually in the spring season when there are a lot of pollens. And asthma is also seen in mostly in the, otherwise asthma is there throughout the year. But asthma is also most frequently seen in the spring season as well as in the winter season. So there are so many diseases which have the seasonal distribution, which have the periodic fluctuations. So if we look at either it is the viral or the vector-borne or it is the bacterial. So why in winters, you must be asking me, ma'am? Because the droplets, the infections which are airborne, which spreads through the respiratory droplets. So these droplets stays in the air for a long period of time. So droplets who have a size of less than 5 micrometer, so they spread, they are suspended in the air, and this is the reason that most of the respiratory infection, most of the airborne droplets are occurring in the winter season. So we have, now we can see there is a seasonal distribution of certain diseases. So that is occurring over time. So this was also a myth that coronavirus won't be there in the summertime, but it is still there. Then coming to the place distribution. So place distribution is that some diseases are related to specific places. For example, see, some diseases we have already studied in the first part of the video, that some diseases are endemic. Endemic diseases are the diseases which are in a particular geographic area in a particular population, right? So all these diseases will come under the place distribution. So also like diseases like Kala Azar, or we can say hay fever. So Kala Azar, or we can say hay fever or visceral leishmaniasis. Now Kala Azar, you know, it is from sand fly. How the sand fly looks like? So the sand fly actually looks like it has a red bulb. And the sand fly comes from the Leishmania family. So exactly, if you ask me, then phlebotomus. So this is actually a fly is the vector which is causing this Kala Azar. Why Kala Azar? Kala means black in Hindi. Azar, see, Kala Azar is actually also Kal, it is from Kal word. So Kal is a kind of a danger, or it is deadly or fatal, we can say. So what happens when this fly, it bites somebody, there is also a darkening of the color, darkening of the skin along with the fever. So this is Kala because fever is also there, plus darkening of the skin is there. So this is Kala Azar, and it is usually seen in, see, there are national and international variants. So if we look at the globally, then the Brazil, east part of the Africa, India, Bangladesh, Nepal, all these parts are most commonly affected with the Kala Azar. And also, if you look at the national variation is there, the national or geographic variation. So the most commonly states which are affected are the eastern part of UP. So especially Varanasi, Gonda, and Balia. So all these, and maximum it is present in the Bihar. It is seen in the Bihar because of the humidity, because of the humid and the warm vegetation. So the sand fly is most commonly present there. So maximum it is seen in Bihar. Also, it is also present in the West Bengal, then Jharkhand, and then it is lastly least commonly present in the UP. Not all of the UP, just the eastern part of the UP. So this Kala Azar is a good example of place distribution. And actually, testing the Kala Azar, see, there are visceral leishmaniasis because it is coming from, the sand fly is coming from a leishmania family. There is also cutaneous leishmaniasis. And if you have seen any patient of leishmaniasis, actually, even after the treatment, these scars won't go. So this is a affecting disease, because especially females, there will be a scar will be always present. So how do we test this? There is a globulin ring test. So what do? We take the serum, we dilute it 10 to 20 times, and then we put the saline in the test tube. Now, after that, in the test tube, we put small amount of distilled water. And once we are putting that distilled water, there will be a distinct white ring which is going to form on the serum. So this is our, like that we have, we have many tested. So one example is the Kalazar. Place distribution, we have many examples. It can be the Japanese encephalitis. So, Japanese encephalitis. There are not many cases which I've reported, but from past few years, cases have been reported. Now, this Japanese encephalitis, why Japanese encephalitis? Now, you will be asking, it is most commonly occurring in the Asia and Western Pacific. So, then you will be asking, ma'am, why only Japanese? Is it occurring only in the Japan? No, the first case was actually found in the Japan. And encephalitis, enceph means brain, itis means inflammation. So in this, there is an inflammation of the brain. There is actually swelling of the brain, which is due to a mosquito, which is due to the Culex mosquito. Also, there are so many diseases from the Culex mosquito. We have dengue from Culex, we have yellow fever from Culex, also the Western Nile infection fever from the Culex. So many diseases from Culex. So if you ask me which form of Culex, I don't remember. It is actually Culex tritani or Hincus. So this is most commonly form of Culex which causes Japanese encephalitis. So this is Japanese encephalitis virus is there, and this virus is also present in the pigs and wild birds. So basically, this is also an example of the place distribution. And if you look at in India also, there is international, see, there is an international distribution is present, because it is usually seen in the Asia and the West Pacific parts. And if you look at the place distribution, it is occurring in the Tamil Nadu, UP and West Bengal. But I think that Tamil Nadu, there are no death rates, but UP and West Bengal, we still have death rates from this. Then again, coming to the most common, you will be telling, ma'am, you are telling uncommon, which we haven't seen. So the most common is the malaria, right? Then you must be asking, ma'am, why malaria is a place distribution? We have seen malaria affecting all of the countries. So if you look at the worldwide, there are 92 countries which are most commonly affected with the malaria. And 92 out of 92 countries, you see Africa and the Asia are the most commonly, they are the high risk for malaria actually. So, and go to India, then India, we have the northeast states, the Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Gujarat, Rajasthan, then Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh. So these are most commonly affected by malaria. And I'll tell you a story. I went to Goa with my friends once, and when we came back, we went driving from Bangalore. When we came back, everybody who went there, we got malaria. So, if you are traveling to Kolkata, Mumbai, Varanasi, New Delhi, Goa, then there are high chances that you get the malaria. And especially, see, again, it is an example of place also. It is an example for the period also, seasonal. If you remember, because it is most commonly occurring in the monsoon season, it is most commonly occurring in the rainy season. So, it comes in both the examples. Then we have malaria from female anopheles, plasmodium, falciparum, most commonly affected, then malaria, then ovale, vivax. So ovale was previously not reported in India. From malaria from plasmodium ovale was actually not reported. But now we have cases from ovale also. Okay, then we have HIV which has a place distribution. Now you must be telling me, ma'am, this time here you are wrong. No, my dear friends, HIV also has a place distribution. Even though it is worldwide, but there are many specific regions in which there are most common cases, there are the maximum cases of HIV which are present, which are seen. So HIV has most commonly affected countries is the South Africa, देन वी हैव नाइजीरिया, देन वी हैव इंडिया. सो दीज आर द बेसिकली हाई रिस्क कंट्रीज. एंड इफ वी लुक एट द नेशनल वेरिएशन, देन ऑल्सो इन इंडिया वी हैव द मोस्ट कॉमनली इज द तमिलनाडु, कर्नाटका, देन आंध्र प्रदेश, देन महाराष्ट्र, नागालैंड, मणिपुर. सो ऑल दीज कंट्रीज आर ऑल्सो एन एग्जाम्पल फॉर विच आर मोस्ट कॉमनली अफेक्टेड बाई एच आई वी, एंड एच आई वी हैज द प्लेस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ओके, देन वट यू हैव रेड ऑफ इन द प्लेस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बाय नाउ इज द फ्लोरोसिस. सो फ्लोरोसिस इज अगेन, इट इज अ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ प्लेस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन बिकॉज इट इज मोस्ट कॉमनली सी अदरवाइज बिकॉज ऑफ द वॉटर कंटेंट, हाई फ्लोराइड कंटेंट इन द वॉटर, इट इज प्रेजेंट इन ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया. बट सर सम रीजन्स आर मेजरली अफेक्टेड, सम रीजन्स आर मॉडरेटली अफेक्टेड, सम रीजन्स आर माइल्डली अफेक्टेड. सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट मैक्सिमम स्टेट्स आर द राजस्थान, आंध्र प्रदेश, कर्नाटका, देन मॉडरेटली वी हैव मध्य प्रदेश, पंजाब, हरियाणा, देन वी हैव महाराष्ट्र. सो लाइक दैट, दैट इज ऑल्सो एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द प्लेस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. देन कम्स द पर्सन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सी पर्सन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मीन्स सर्टन डिजीजेस आर रिलेटेड टू सर्टन पर्सन, लाइक इन दैट रेस विल ऑल्सो कम. सो इन दैट सपोज एज, देर आर मेनी डिजीजेज विच वी सी आर एज रिलेटेड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल डायबिटीज, हाइपरटेंशन, then we have the heart disease, then we have see these disease, then we have cancer also, Alzheimer's disease. So all these diseases are occurring above the year of 40 years, so most commonly fourth or fifth decade of life. Then we have cataract, which you have seen only in the old age, that are above 50 years of age, so fifth to sixth decade of life, right? Like that we have certain diseases which are occurring in the children also, like see, like measles from 6 months to 3 years. And also if you see, we have so many dental diseases which are also age related, like early childhood caries, we have covered in the pedo. So early childhood caries are also occurring in the children. We have so many oral habits, so especially thumb sucking habit, which is seen in the children. Then we have certain diseases which are age related, again the residual resorption, which is seen mostly after the 6th decade of life. Then we have xerostomia, root caries. Xerostomia is age related because of the drug association, because so many drugs actually causes xerostomia. So drugs like beta blockers, diuretic, anticonvulsant, so all these drug causes xerostomia, and that is why it is most commonly seen after the 40 years. Also we have root caries, so that is also seen in the older age above 40, 4th, 5th decade. Next comes the sex. So in the person distribution, there are also certain diseases which are frequently in the females, certain diseases which are frequent in the males. So in the females we have pregnancy tumor, Sjogren syndrome, rheumatoid arthritis, then we have anorexia nervosa, which is most commonly seen because of the dieting, right? Then we have breast cancer, then we have cervical cancer, also gingivitis is seen in most commonly in the females. Then we have certain diseases in the males, like heart disease, cancer, especially oral cancer, COPD. So all these diseases are most frequently or occurring in the males. So this is about the descriptive epidemiology. And this descriptive epidemiology, it uses either a cross-sectional study or a longitudinal study to obtain the magnitude of the disease in human population. So how we are estimating the magnitude of the health, magnitude of the disease problems? So how we are looking at these problems? See, there are two approaches. One is the cross-sectional study. Cross-sectional study means there is a one long disease. This disease is occurring from 30 years of age, and this disease is occurring up till 60 years of age. So people who are at 30 years of age are also getting the disease. who are at 60 years of age are also getting the disease, who are at 50 years of age are also getting, 55 years of age are also getting. And so this kind of study, if we are taking one individual, right, and we are studying this individual, studying the health, studying the disease problems related to any disease to the whole lifetime, to the whole period of time, is the longitudinal study. That means for a long period of time we are studying. Cross-sectional studies, we are taking the cross-sections, like we are taking a person at 35 years of age having this disease, we are taking a person at 50 years of age having this disease, we are taking a person at 55 of age having this disease, and we are studying about the disease, the magnitude of the health and the disease problems. So cross-sectional studies are most useful for a chronic, for a long-term disease, for a chronic disease, and then the short-lived diseases. So basically studying the hypertension, we can say. So this can be an example of the cross-sectional study. So long-term disease, because we can study at some durations. So the cross-sections, we can take some cross-sections and we can study about the disease. Longitudinal studies, when a certain population is studied over a long period of time and also till the follow-up examinations. So for that is our longitudinal study. So longitudinal study is used for any history of the disease or identification of any risk factor of the disease. So, and also the rate of occurrence, find out the basically the incidences rate, the new cases. So for that we use the longitudinal studies. So we have these two kinds of study, the cross-sectional study as well as the longitudinal study. So in the cross-sectional study, we are taking new people every time. And in longitudinal study, we are taking same people for the whole time. So this is the main difference between the cross-sectional study and the longitudinal study. So guys, this is about the descriptive epidemiology. Next video, we are going to talk about the analytical epidemiology. In the analytical epidemiology, we are going to talk about the case control as well as the cohort study. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this video, and if you have liked the video, give it a thumbs up, and also you can comment in the comment section below and in the description box below. Now you have a chance to support me on Patreon as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So guys, take care, bye bye, tata, keep studying, keep learning. I will see you soon, guys.